In this circuit, we explain the working principle of a PC power supply, which has to transform a 240 alternate voltage to a 12 direct voltage. We see a basic circuit which can do it, the full bridge rectifier. The goal of the power supply is turning the 240 house voltage to a 12 or 5 direct voltage suitable for our PC components. To reach our goal, we need some key components. The first is a transformer, which is an element that transforms an alternate voltage in a higher or lower alternate voltage. So it is an element that can change the voltage level. Fundamental for us who want to turn 240 volts into 12 volts. Specifically, this is a step-down transformer. If N1 is the turn number of the first coil and N2 is the turn number of the second coil, and if V1 is our applied voltage and V2 is our transformed voltage, the basic transformer relation states that V1 V2 is equal to N1 N2. Being V1 240 volts and wanting V2 as 12 volts, we need a turn ratio of 20. Actually, 12 is the final value we want to obtain, but at this level we need some more volts, more or less 12.7 volts. We see why later. If you want to go deeper on transformers, I leave you a link on the description. So, transformer lower the voltage level, but we still have an alternate voltage, so we need other components. In order to rectify the alternate current, we can use a diode bridge. A diode is a component which allows the current to pass only in one direction, blocking it on the other. When the current passes, we have a 0.7 volt drop on the component. Such component is perfect to rectify current and voltage. We can use a configuration like this one, in which, as you can see, even changing the polarity of the input current, the output is kept at a fixed polarity. In this animation, we can understand better the circuit. We apply our alternate current on the input, and because of the diode bridge, we cut all the negative current, transforming it into positive ones. So our output wave follows the input shape, but turning it into positive. What you see is not exactly what happened, because we have to keep in mind the voltage drop on the diodes. So the output voltage is cut off on the highs, and real voltage peak is Vout less 0.7 volts. That's why we want more than 12 volts at the output of the transformer. So now we have a voltage more or less of 12 volts, and this is the current path during the negative half cycle. The output is always positive, but it goes from 12 volts to zero, and this is not properly direct current. We need to stabilize it. In order to stabilize it, we use a proper capacitor on the output. The capacitor cannot discharge quickly, so it lowers slowly its voltage till the next recharge cycle, and so on. In this way, we have a very little variation of our output voltage, that now can be called direct voltage. We can add more capacitor for further stabilization. In this way, we have our final circuit. This is more or less the working way of the AC-DC converter, and how the alternate voltage of our house is turned into direct, suitable for our personal computer. If you need some clarification about capacitors, I leave you a link in the description. So, more or less, this circuit is what you can find in all electronic devices taking the power from your house, if they need the direct current. Now, let's simulate this circuit in the Easy IDA electronic simulator, just to check the working. Here you can see the circuit with N1 N2 ratio of 19. We apply a sinusoidal wave of 50 Hz and 240 volts peak, similar to the AC voltage in our houses. At the output of the transformer, we get this situation where the blue line is the transformer output and the yellow line is the sinusoidal input. You see the transformer stepped down the voltage. Adding the diode bridge, we have at the output this blue line always positive, where the yellow line is the sinusoidal input. Eventually, adding the capacitor, we have this stable blue line, which is our DC voltage. This is the circuit you can find in all the power supplies you need for your electronic devices. Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put that thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.